We launch today into the controversy over cruising with so much at stake for South Florida. This week, Florida, via Governor Ron DeSantis, sued the CDC over new cruising guidelines and also lack of a restart date.
At Port Miami on Friday afternoon, a wide array of bipartisan elected officials, cruise line executives, union leaders all gathered to speak with one voice about the need to start cruising again, hopefully by July. And one Miami-based cruise line is threatening to possibly start sending its ships out from ports in other more receptive countries.
That cruise line is Carnival, with its world headquarters right here in Miami. Christine Duffy is the president, and she is with us, as you see, live. Christine Duffy, welcome. Great to have you.
Christine, welcome. We are glad to see you.
Good morning. Thank you for having me.
Okay, it's great to have you here. All right, let's begin with sort of the most basic question, which is, on Friday afternoon, you and your contemporaries from every other major cruise line said, we need to get our ships back out there. We need to get back to work. 60,000 or so workers directly, indirectly affected here in South Florida at Port Miami. How are you going to do that by July?
Well, that's really why we are engaging and so appreciative of the bipartisan support that we're receiving to restart cruising. So that's really the ask at this point. And we are engaging with our federal government as well as the CDC to lift the current conditional sail order that was issued last October.
That came with, Christine Duffy, a number of stipulations, if you will. The CDC is, in sort of a public sense, framing what it thinks is a healthy way, a safe way to start cruising. And this Friday gathering was kind of a blowback to that. Can you talk a little bit about what is wrong with the CDC recommendations and stipulations and standards, which right now sort of sets the standard for when cruises can restart?
Well, we believe that the current conditional sail order, first of all, was issued last October before there were vaccines. We had been working with the CDC to look at restart of cruising once we had testing available and we began to better understand COVID and how to protect and prevent. We have been sailing in other parts of the world since last June. Over 400,000 people have taken cruises everywhere but outside, but the US. So right now, the conditional sail order does not reflect vaccines. And there's also a great deal of information that has not yet been communicated to the cruise lines, from what will be required for test cruises, what kind of testing may be required. So we really just don't have the details or transparency or engagement with CDC that we need to begin sailing by this summer, which is such an important season for the cruise industry and for vacationers.
Yeah, Christine Duffy, you seem to be saying the CDC is sort of dragging its feet, not going as fast as you and the cruise industry would like. Is that accurate?
Well, we respect certainly the CDC and the work that they are doing at a much broader scale. But at the same time, the cruise industry, as far as we know, is the only industry that has not been able to operate for more than a year when we voluntarily paused last March. And we have worked together as an industry to develop layers of protection and provided the CDC with recommendations that we collectively agreed to as cruise lines so that we could restart sailing. And so we're asking now for the CDC to work with us so that we can have clarity on what will be required to resume sailing from our U.S. home ports.
All right, if I could follow up, Christine, with just an important question. As you know, the day before your news conference, Governor Ron DeSantis was at Port Miami, and he said he did not believe that the cruise lines should be required to have their passengers give proof that they had been vaccinated before they get on board your ships. Where does Carnival stand? Will you require passengers on Carnival ships to show proof of vaccination or to be proved negative before they get on board?
We are not making those decisions as a cruise line. We do not believe that the cruise industry in the US should be treated any differently than other forms of travel, tourism, or entertainment. And so at this time, people are able to get on a plane and fly outside of the US, take a cruise, and come back into the US without requirements like a vaccine or a health passport. So our position is don't treat cruise industry differently than everyone else. We have put together a set of protocols that we believe give prevention protection. And as I said, we've demonstrated in other parts of the world that we've been able to sail safely even before vaccines.
So you make a fair point when you compare cruise liners to other forms of entertainment. But then cruise liners are so different than other forms of entertainment in that there's a residential component, especially 3 days, 7 days, 10 days. People, a lot of people, are living together in close quarters, sharing a lot of public spaces as if, well, they do live aboard. And that's not something that you can compare to a casino or an airplane or a hotel. So the CDC is, what it appears from reading the standards, is it's treating cruise liners like a residence. And as such, there is a CDC guideline prior to COVID that you actually, and I read a report from last September, really backed the CDC's guidance. So what's changed?
Well, first of all, vaccines have changed. What's also changed is the treatments and therapies that are available today for COVID. And certainly a year ago, when we put our pause in place, there was great concern about the capacity in hospitals if there was a spread of the virus. And while you say that we are different than a casino, because large casinos have hotels in the casino building, people are gathered together. And we have addressed some of those concerns around crowding by saying that we will limit our capacity at the point of restart so that we will be able to support any physical distancing requirements that are needed. We've not really heard back specifically, again, on what the protocols will be for people when they take a cruise.
Yeah. Christine, as we know, there are cruises that are operating out of Asia, out of the Mediterranean. These are not U.S.-owned cruise lines, and they appear to be doing okay. There have not been huge outbreaks of coronavirus on board these ships. If you find the CDC to be so recalcitrant and so difficult, would Carnival consider basing more of its ships in other countries?
Well, I've always said Carnival Cruise Line is America's cruise line. We sail from 14 U.S. home ports around the U.S. A large percentage of our guests actually drive to their cruise vacation and can do so in 5 hours or less. So we really do not want to have to move our ships out of U.S. home ports. There are several cruise lines that have already begun doing that because at some level, we will have no choice if we can't gain clarity and alignment on what it will take to restart cruising from the U.S. But what doesn't make sense is that somebody can get on a plane, book a cruise out of the Caribbean for June, fly to that cruise, take the cruise, and come right back into the U.S.
Carnival has 14 home ports, its world headquarters in Miami. Why aren't the ships themselves registered in the United States?
Well, the cruise industry is, we are registered, our ships are registered in various countries. That's been the way that the cruise industry has always operated because we move around in international waters. And so our regulation comes under the International Maritime Organization.
Yeah, very briefly, Christine, let me ask you, Governor DeSantis is suing the CDC. Does Carnival support that lawsuit by the state of Florida?
Well, that is really up to the governor. We appreciate Governor DeSantis's support, and I think his frustration, because we do have a sense of urgency that we need clarity in order to restart sailing if we're going to be able to do so this summer. And so we know that there are other governors, there are other places, the state of Alaska. The governor there has also announced that they are looking into a lawsuit because in Alaska, most of the tourists that they get come by cruise ships. Yeah. So this is not limited to Florida. Florida and certainly South Florida is the cruise capital of the world, where we have more ships and more guests that are embarking here. And it is tied to many, many jobs in this community. And so putting the cruise lines aside, I think the focus and the concern that the governor and other representatives who you saw Friday at the Port of Miami is that we need to get people back to work here. And yeah, that's why we are asking this time.
We heard you and we heard them loud and clear at the port on Friday. Christine Duffy, great to speak with you, and good luck with getting your ships back at sea again.
Thanks so much.
Thank you.